Hey kids, what's up? My name is Joey Kidney and welcome to today's Camp Bell activity. I've been doing YouTube for 8 years now, but on the side, I love doing photography. And I know there's a lot of you out there who want to give it a try. So today, I'm here to teach you some tips. But first, let's talk equipment. You don't need a big camera with a big lens to make it look all intimidating when all you need is your phone. Now to put it all in perspective, let me show you some shots that I took on this. Now let me show you what I've taken on my Galaxy S10. Now I don't want to start off this video by telling you I'm a liar, but those shots were actually flipped. The photos that I said I took on this, I really took on this, and vice versa. The photos that I said I took on this, I took on this. Could you tell? Now, like I said, I have a Samsung Galaxy S10. But before we go out and start shooting with this, you need to know the three basic, the most simple rules of photography. The three things that you really, really need to know. One, shutter speed, two, aperture, and three, ISO. Let me explain this like an eyeball. The shutter speed is how fast you are blinking. The slower you blink, the more light you let in. The faster you blink, the quicker your shot's gonna be, which means less light. The aperture is similar to your pupil. Yes, this big black dot in the middle of your eye. That is very similar. You know at nighttime when you're walking around and it's pitch black and that black dot takes up most of your eyeball? Well, that's because it's trying to get as much light in as possible so you can see at night. And that is what your camera will be doing as well. And the ISO is the light created by your sensor, which I like to call fake light. But just know, the higher ISO you have, the more grain and noise and grossness you're gonna be having in your photos. And I know you're thinking, well, I don't have a camera, so why is this gonna matter? Well, it's just very good to know the basics because you can even apply those to your phone. Now, let's grab your phone and let's do something. How many times have you grabbed your phone, you've gone out, you wanted to take a picture, and you held up your camera and it didn't see what you wanted it to? Now, on this phone, when you go up to the sky and you tap what you want to expose for, and then there's a slider that pops up, and you can drag that slider up and down, and it will increase the brightness of the photo, which would be what? Your exposure. Now, next up is a really, really cool one. So we're gonna go outside. So I want you to find a building or a big object that you're gonna put in the center of your camera. So make sure you frame it up properly, put it in the center, and then go all the way over and do hyperlapse, or if your phone has time lapse. Make sure you're standing really far away from this subject because you're gonna be walking closer. So you're gonna hit record and slowly walk closer. And make sure that your object is always in the center of your frame so it doesn't move too much. And this is what it's gonna look like. And for the final trick, we're gonna be using slow-mo. So again, I want you to go outside and find a flower, find a frog, a dog, whatever it appeals to you. Now this is important. I want you to go as close to your object as you can where you can focus. I want you to tap on the focus button and then start recording. What that's gonna do is that it's gonna lock the focus. I want you to back up really, really quickly and then slowly go right back in to your object and to the point where you get focus again. And it's gonna look something like this. And that's all the tips I have for you guys today. I really hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. I hope you had fun. But what I want you to take from this entire thing is this one thing. You do not always need the best equipment to get the best photo. Don't rely just on having the fanciest stuff. You can do it even with your phone. So go out and shoot, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.